She's on the nest, presumably feeding her babies, but maybe she's protecting them from all these mosquitoes. I seen her hunting up by the house this morning. And it was still twilight. Yeah, she's got lots of work to do. There's a nice one. I took it because it looked like it was getting a little slimy on the bottom. I didn't know if a mice had chewed it or whatever, but sometimes when they get slimy, then that's it, they turn black and they rot in the center. So, with all this humidity, they're vulnerable. I'd rather take it now than have it rot out, waiting for it to get bigger. Daddy is there feeding them. Oh, that's Mama. I got mosquitoes biting me. Can't hold it. Wow. Mosquitoes are bad. I'm gonna try not to drink any coffee today. I know I've been drinking too much. I got some mint from the back. One new Great Leaf and one little new Comfrey Leaf. I want to make tea out of this, see if I can't wean myself of the coffee and heavy cream I've been substituting for breakfast. I think I had 50 of those birds in my backyard as I walked through here, so I started making these noises. They're kind of hanging around. Normally they're fairly shy. Starlings and grackles. But most people want to shoot them. I let them go. Not a problem. There is a little baby house wren right there. You better learn how to catch bugs. The last of the blackberries. I'm just fresh picking them now. There really isn't enough to come back here and fill a bowl or a container or whatever. Next is going to be wild blackberries, about a month. As I mentioned in a previous video, the butternut squash is growing on top of itself. It's coming up and it's growing another layer. You've got lots of squash in here. I actually walked back here and made a little some holes here so I can get along here and get at the tomatoes when they're starting to become ripe. Another squash here. I saw them all throughout the whole system here. Now they're blossoming with their second layer here. There's even some squash that's as high as the tomatoes already came up through, going up the fence. So eventually they're going to work their way over to the hazelnuts. I mean, the tomatoes are too, but the squash looks like they're going to beat them. We have our first kind of ripe sun gold right here. I'm picking it right now. And I am gonna eat it. Pretty good. So some of the corn is gonna be lost because the squash is growing that fast. That's okay, it's an experiment, see what happens. and I don't expect the corn to be fully pollinated. Unless maybe I go in there and do a little hand pollinating if I can get in there. The squash is definitely the better of the crop between squash and corn. I just want some corn to do a little fermenting in the winter for a little bit of a different meal. So we'll see what happens. It's really growing like crazy. And it's got to be the squash here in the center, right there. It's got to be 3 foot tall. It's growing on top of itself. Here she comes. She's right there. There she is. I just want to get a look. Yeah, look at that. Oh, male's here too. He's right there. He's right in there. Okay, I'm leaving. Coming to defend the nest. Alright. There's Daddy. Been hanging around here for a while and now he's guarding. Not that I think that anybody is wondering why I'm running around in an old pickup truck with 372,000 miles on it. I got a delivery today. Not really an impulse buy, but I wasn't going to buy this early in the year, this early in the season, early meaning it's the end of July. I really don't want to plant anything until October. Because they require too much care now. But I'm afraid they're going to sell out because everything is selling out right now. This is what I bought and I paid a ton of money. And I want some more. All different types in here. There's actually, one of them I bought two of because it was a production. A real beast. That's a production variety. They're like blue banana, that sounds interesting, doesn't it? Takantana. What's this one? Giant heart. Yeah, I want to eat some giant heart. Alright, I'm gonna plant these. They're now free from their pots. I can pull them out. These people, they really pack their trees well. So this is the smallest one right here. It's a pretty nice looking growth. I'm willing to bet they had a bigger one and something happened to it. It's a new sprout. I don't know. I'll figure it out when I take it out of the pot. But they had this wet newspaper on top so it wouldn't dry out. But I ordered it Sunday, I think. And today's Friday. I got it already. Cost a ton of money. But I built this gardening set up here with a chicken wire roof and walls to keep the catbirds and the cardinals and the robins away from the honeyberries. So I think I received one more plant than I really wanted to order, but I ordered two of something. I'm going to be revamping this. This is also honeyberries. I think I'll leave those there. I'm thinking about moving them, but I'm thinking I'm going to leave them there. I leave the row of asparagus here. Then I've got six of them in along the edges over there, and I'm going to put them in this bed this fall, this October. I'm going to plant asparagus along the fence. And on this side, where I'm going to be planting these, I might not be able to fit them all, but I got to think about it a little bit. Right now I've got a berry blue in the corner, and I have one. Well, I only have two over here. I also have gooseberry, and the gooseberries can come out. They're not susceptible susceptible. I can't even say it. Susceptible to the birds. The berries are too big. And the skins are pretty tough too. I think that might deter them a little bit. But there's some in here I just saw. Let's get this stinging nettle out of my way. Here's one right here. Something wrong with it. I'll have to check it out. That's what I want. I've already picked this one a couple times. This is a captive area. It can come out of here. This is actually a real small representation, so that didn't work out to describe what they are. They're like three or four times that size. So I have a honeyberry right here. That's a special one I bought too for big money in the same place. So this one is going to be moving over into this bed here. And I got another one that's moving over. So that means I got six to plant. And when this thing is cleared, I'm going to be planting asparagus in here too. So there'll be asparagus on both sides of the fence. And then I'm going to be planting a honeyberry here because this black currant is going to be leaving the property. One, two, three, four, then the other two on this side, and then adding the two that are on the fence already, that'll be four on this side. So there'll be eight honeyberry plants here. I didn't order one too many. And this is the center path here, the bricks. And there'll be honeyberries on both sides, and then I'll be able to get around the back of the bed to be able to harvest honeyberries. So, and then this here, the blackberries did so well this year, maybe they'll make it again next year. So instead of asparagus over there, I'll leave the blackberries. Kind of like the plan. And I've got this chicken wire fence, and I've got this male grape to shade them in the heat of the summer. Because grapes leaf out very late. So that'll slow the growth down of these plants like I want. And they'll last longer, they'll be fresher. Otherwise, if you got them in full sun, I've read that they can lose all their leaves and get set back. That's why I'm doing this. All right, I got some planting to do. Planting a honeyberry bush is as simple as digging a hole. But there is a little twist to it. Let me show you in a sec. So here it is. And I'm looking at this branch here, and it kind of looks like it's wanting to lean back this way, and that's the way it was getting the sun, is over this way here. So I planted it the way I think the sun was hitting it. And now here's a little twist. You see, I got a cavity between the medium that the plant was in the pot and the side of the hole. So I'm collapsing the side of the hole with my fingers to make sure way down on the bottom is not, there's no air there. I'm getting it down in there. Down under there. There, now I'll bring the rest of the soil in. You can hear the cardinal in the background. The little squeaks are feeding its baby here while I'm doing this. Probably 10 feet away from me right now. They're really getting used to me. So I'm experimenting with mound layering honeyberries, and it works. So I'm going to get the soil up over the top of where it originally was planted. So now both of these two are going to be growing roots, and if I elect to, I can dig it out and have two plants, or just have more roots, more feeder roots to grow more berries than with one plant. This was the other one that I planted. Kind of rushed out of here because I didn't want she come to feed, and I wanted to get away, but sounds like she's just not worried too much about me. All right, got one more plant. Evman, this was the little one inside of this bed of white salsify and beets, and because it was little, I was able to fit it in there pretty nicely. And we have one here in the end. This one was the weirdest shaped one. So I put it here, and I got a stick here kind of holding up a little bit. The roots are forward, but the plant is backwards, so there's a little more sunlight coming backwards. Here we have the giant hearts here. This is going to have the most room to roam. I'm taking out this black currant. Another one here. Another one here. And I felt like I am not going to get another one in here. So I'm probably going to put another row right in there. If not, then this one will be by itself here. See, right in there, you see the tag. Or I can transplant it later. We've got this carrot here, and I'm going to be digging these roots out in the spring. And I don't want to dig the honeyberry out again. Well, maybe I harvest all the roots, and then I transplant that honeyberry from here to over here. That's probably the best thing. Because I want that to be a bed of asparagus and blackberries. So now we have room for two more here. When I harvest these white salsify next spring, I'll put another one here, and then I'll harvest this parsley root, and I'll put another one here. And those two are already planted on that fence line. And I'll be really socking it in with asparagus in here. Asparagus and honeyberries. Sounds like a plan. Honeyberries and asparagus. That sounds like I'm the man with the plan. She looks so plump and happy. Here are black currants that are bletting on the vine. And they are rather delicious to eat that way. Yep. Get a couple more here. Kind of like a little bit like a prune. Makes sense, right? They're very soft. Yeah, I like it. Haven't done that before. I produced bumblebee heaven here in my backyard. This is a radish that I allowed to go to blossom and seed. It's a hybrid, so I don't really want to save the seed for replanting, but I do want to save the seed pods with developing seed for salad. So I got a lot of mosquitoes out here. I'm not going to clean it all off here. I'm going to break that off and bring it in the house. Get sent down there. It ain't going to grow anymore, so we're going to bring that in and add it to the salad. There's another one. Pretty nice. I was working some sticks here from a honey locust tree that I had pruned. And the lopers that I was using was making pretty loud noise, and I was kind of right here, and then I got stung. They weren't happy with me. There's a couple hundred of them on the outside there. They're getting ready to get after me. We like those around here because they eat a lot of bugs.